Go.
All of humanity that has ever lived in the last 50,000 years can be fit into a volume the size of this little dice. Every square inch of your body is being bombarded with 65 billion neutrinos per second, and they come directly from the sun, although you don't feel it. The night sky contains 10 sextillion stars, but all of the grains of sand on Earth counts up to only 5 sextillion. The atom is considered a fundamental particle in the universe, but did you know that there's a particle that's 10 power 24 times smaller than the size of the atom? No. 4 billion years from now, our Milky Way galaxy and the Andromeda galaxy will collide. They will undergo a 1 billion year dance. But my question to you is, will the stars between both of those galaxies collide? Now, before I answer all those questions, if it's not clear by now, I love physics. I love the cosmos, I love studying the cosmos, but I also love particle physics, and I realized that in order to understand the cosmos better, I need to be able to understand the particles that make up the cosmos. And I want to share that with you all today. I threw some big numbers out there. If I told you, run 2 miles versus, okay, now go run 5 miles, you'll be able to understand your perceived exhaustion or your inanition based on how much effort you put in. But if I told you a number 10 billion miles versus 100 trillion miles, the human brain cannot comprehend those numbers. Well, today, when I answer these questions that I asked earlier, I'm going to try to put these things in perspective for you all. Now, I said all of humanity can fit into this little dice, which I have lost, by the way. Here it is. To understand that, let's look at what we're made of. We're all made of atoms. The atom has a nucleus in the center with an electron that spins around it. The atom is 10 power minus 11 meters. We cannot comprehend how small that is. So let me blow up the size of the atom for you all. Let's blow up the size of the nucleus to this ball. If that's the case, the electron will be the size of this little pin, and it will be revolving around the nucleus. And do you know how far? Not 5 feet, not 10 feet, 3 miles. It goes around the nucleus at a distance of 3 miles, and everything between that is just empty space. An atom is 99.9999% empty space. So when I say humanity can be compressed down into a small dice, that's what I mean. Just remove all the empty space, and you can shrink them down to the size of that dice. Let's look at the atom again. I said there's something smaller than the atom. It's called a string. Now, I don't have time to go over what a string is, but a string is 10 power minus 35 meters. Again, how do you compare the sizes? It's hard to compare that. But just for the fun of it, I'm going to add a water molecule right next to it. Now let's compare all three of these. How do they compare in terms of size? To do that, I'm going to blow up the size of the string to the size of a human being. So what does the atom compare to? The Virgo supercluster. It's 100 million light years across. It has 50,000 galaxies, and each one of those galaxies could contain up to 200 or 400 billion stars. Okay, what is the string compared to the size of a water molecule? That's easy. The size of the known universe. At this scale, every dot is a supercluster. Every dot represents 50, maybe 100,000 galaxies. Pretty incomprehensible. Now, I said both our galaxies are gonna collide. In order to understand if the stars are gonna collide, let's go to the Grand Canyon. There are two flies in the Grand Canyon, and they're flying in the opposite direction. Now, the answer to if the stars do collide the chances of these two flies that are flying in the opposite direction, 5 miles apart from each other, that's the probability you have of two stars from opposite galaxies colliding with each other. In other words, not so much of a chance. But if humanity does survive 4 billion years, they will be treated to the greatest light show ever. While they witness the creation of what I would like to call the Milkomeda. Now, I threw some facts at you. I hope I've inspired you to go further research into the cosmos and learn further. But I want to leave you all with this little nugget that I read somewhere. We as human beings are so fortunate to be alive at this time in the universe. If we were present 2 billion years ago, the Earth would be boiling hot lava. We couldn't have survived. Several billion years from now, all the stars and the galaxies would have just faded away. They would have drifted apart. So should humanity survive then, they would look up the sky and all they would see is darkness and wonder, are we alone in this universe?